Welcome back to Developing a Social Media Strategy. Strategy equals the big picture look, focusing on the entire landscape. So tactics, on the other hand, are the meat and bread of the strategy. They are the doing aspect and follows the planning. Well, for one, it gives you direction. It helps you to see the big picture. It keeps you focused on goals, enables you to set measurable objectives. It stops you from making big mistakes. It saves you time. It reduces overwhelm. Success is more sustainable long-term versus short-term. Can easily be transferred to others. It allows you to target primary customer. Enables you to spend budget more efficiently and effectively, helps you remain dedicated and consistent. It allows social media programs to keep growing as well. It helps you determine what works and what doesn't work. And the benefits of a planned social media strategy are numerous. This is nothing about relying on intuition. Now, we're going to be working with the post strategy process in this course. So the post, the P stands for people. So we want to identify who will be involved in social strategy and execution, objectives to deciding what you want to accomplish and having those immeasurable objectives, and strategy, plan for relationship building, collaboration, and integration, and tools, decide which technologies to use. We're going to be using this social media strategic framework. So we already talked about understanding the social web. We're going to be doing a business assessment for your discovery phase, thinking about the target audience, knowing how to do market research before you jump into social media. We're going to be talking about goals and objectives, your resources, and what you truly need to make that plan happen. So the purpose of the strategy and the course, and during the 6 weeks, this is what is going to be our focus: to get your business or organization to answer the important questions. And we will be doing this with these strategic steps. Well, what is your current situation? Who are you trying to reach? Where should we participate? When is the best time to reach our audience? Why will they care about what you have to say? And how are you going to implement or measure? So these are just examples of the questions that we're going to be discussing and things for you to think about in this course.